Everyone is aware of the dangers that an asteroid might cause. Following the extinction of the dinosaurs, it has been established that a single asteroid from outer space is sufficient to destroy our planet. Today, we'll discuss NASA's disaster preparedness drill, including the recently launched mission which will assist the Earth's safety from any asteroid collisions. So, how does NASA intend to put this to the test? Is this mission truly capable of saving humanity from extinction? In today's video, you'll learn more about these details. The Double Asteroid Redirection Test, a NASA space mission, aims to test a planetary defense method against near-Earth objects. In September 2022, a space probe will collide with Dimorphos, the minor planet moon of the twin asteroid Didymos, to examine the future potential of a spacecraft's impact to divert an asteroid on a collision course with Earth via momentum transfer. DART was developed in collaboration with NASA and the Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory. It is overseen by NASA's Planetary Defense Coordination Office, with technical support from various NASA laboratories and offices. NASA approved the project in August 2018, allowing it to move forward with the final design and construction phase. DART was successfully launched on November 24, 2021, and the collision is scheduled for the end of 2022. Initially, the European Space Agency and NASA had different plans for missions to test asteroid deflection strategies. Still, by 2015, they had formed a cooperation called ADA, which stands for Asteroid Impact and Deflection Assessment. According to the concept, AIM, the European spacecraft, would have launched in December 2020 and DART in July 2021. AIM would have orbited the larger asteroid in order to study its composition and that of its moon. DART will crash with the asteroid's moon in September 2022 during a near approach to Earth. AIM would have investigated the asteroid's strength, surface physical attributes, internal structure, and the impact on the asteroid's moon's orbit around the larger asteroid. Due to the cancellation of the AIM orbiter, the asteroids will not be thoroughly described, and the effects of the DART's collision will be tracked using ground-based telescopes and radar. DART was supposed to be a secondary payload on a commercial launch to keep costs low, but the mission now has its own launch vehicle, according to a mission update presentation in November 2018. Now, let's talk features. Aside from a sun sensor, a star tracker, and asteroid camera for optical navigation, or Draco camera, with a 20-centimeter aperture, the DART spacecraft is a 610-kilogram impactor with no scientific cargo. Draco is based on the long-range reconnaissance imager on board the New Horizons probe and will offer autonomous guidance to impact the asteroid's moon near its center. The DART mission uses the NEXT ion thruster, a type of solar electric propulsion using 240 square foot solar panels, which will generate the power to boost the NASA's evolutionary xenon thruster commercial engine. The solar arrays on the spacecraft are inspired by the ROSA design, which was tested in June 2017 on the International Space Station as part of Expedition 52, carried to the station by SpaceX's CRS-11 commercial cargo mission. Using ROSA as the structure, a small chunk of the DART solar array is constructed to showcase transformational solar array technology, which uses very high-efficiency solar cells and reflecting concentrators to generate three times the power of the current solar array technology. The spiral radial line slot array, a revolutionary type of high-gain communication antenna, is being used for the first time on the DART mission. The antenna operates on the NASA Deep Space Network's X-band frequencies. The finished antenna fits all requirements and has been rigorously tested in various scenarios, resulting in a more straightforward design. The spacecraft's fueling began on October 2021 at the Vandenberg Space Force Base in California as part of DART's launch preparations. The spacecraft arrived at the Vandenberg Space Force Base near Lompoc in early October after a cross-country mission. Since then, members of the DART team have been testing the spacecraft's mechanics and electrical system, wrapping the last pieces in multi-layer insulation blankets and modeling the launch sequence from both the launch site and APL's Mission Operations Center. DART arrived at the SpaceX Payload Processing Facility on VSFB on October 2021. 2 days later, the crew received authorization to fill DART's fuel tank with approximately 50 kilograms of hydrazine propellant for spacecraft movements and attitude control. On November 2021, engineers began attaching the spacecraft to the adapter atop the SpaceX Falcon 9 launch vehicle. The Falcon 9 rocket started rolling for a static fire before actually returning to the processing facility, where SpaceX engineers installed the two halves of the payload fairing around the space probe over 2 days, November 16 and November 17, inside the SpaceX payload processing facility at Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. The ground teams finished a successful flight readiness review with the fairing attached later that week. So, what was the launch of the DART mission like? The DART spacecraft was launched into orbit on November 24, 2021. Early designs called for DART to be launched into a high-altitude Earth orbit to prevent colliding with the Moon. DART would break out of its high Earth orbit and enter a slightly inclined near-Earth solar orbit, from which it would begin heading towards the projected target collision. This would be possible thanks to its low-thrust, high-efficiency ion engine. The payload and the Falcon 9's second stage were set on a direct Earth-to-escape trajectory because DART was launched as a special Falcon 9 mission. DART has a first-of-its-kind electric thruster and plenty of xenon fuel. Still, Falcon 9 completed almost all of the work, leaving only a few trajectory correction burns with simple chemical thrusters as it approached Didymos' moon Dimorphos. What was the impact of the mission? Before answering this question, we would appreciate it if you would like this video and subscribe to our Tech Facts channel. The 500 kilogram DART's impact at 6.6 kilometers per second is predicted to cause a substantial velocity change in the asteroid, resulting in a tiny movement in the asteroid's route, but a considerable shift over time. A prospective Earth-bound asteroid smashing with the planet and killing it utterly could be reduced by the collective process of modifying its trajectory from such a modest shift in velocity over a period of years. The impact will strike Dimorphos right in the center, shortening the orbital period from 11.92 hours to around 10 minutes. The orbital shift and velocity change that will occur is unknown. The momentum augmentation effect is caused by the addition of rebound momentum from the hit. One of the mission's main objectives is to acquire accurate impact measurements, which will aid in updating collision models. The eventual momentum imparted to the asteroid's largest remaining component is expected to be up to 3 to 5 times that of the incident momentum. Preliminary estimates of the shift in the orbit period should be known within a week. A spacecraft dubbed Hera, which the European Space Agency approved in November 2019, will complete a full examination, trial, and evaluation a few years later. What are the targeted asteroids? The mission's purpose is to destroy Dimorphos in the Didymos system, a binary asteroid system in which one asteroid orbits a smaller one. The primary asteroid is roughly 780 meters in diameter, and its minor satellite, Dimorphos, is around 160 meters in diameter and orbits the primary at a distance of about 1 kilometer. Didymos has a mass of 528 billion kilograms, while Dimorphos has a mass of 4.8 billion kilograms. DART will aim at the asteroid Dimorphos. Didymos isn't a planet-crossing asteroid. Therefore, the deflection experiment has a slim possibility of producing a collision.